live today in what you might call the age of knowledge. The age of knowledge, not because knowledge is important, knowledge was always important, but the age of knowledge because knowledge, for the first time in history, became the leading economic commodity. Nations will rise and fall on knowledge, primarily, not only, scientific and technological knowledge. Not only scientific and technological, there are many other kinds of knowledge which are extremely important. Now, science has always been, like art, important, exciting, enriching, all kinds of intellectual aspects, opportunities for creativities. And it always led then to all kinds of applications that led to industry and so on and so forth. But it has never been in history that science and technology became the leading economic commodity. If you look today at numbers in the world, you will see that the sales of Apple company are larger than the oil sales of Venezuela and Iran combined. That gives you an idea of the economic importance of knowledge and technology versus the economic importance of oil or general minerals or natural resources. And any nation that is hoping to advance not only educationally and culturally has to invest in this. And if knowledge, and particularly scientific and technological knowledge, is the leading commodity, then education, and particularly scientific and technological education, is the best investment there is in the world. And I am willing to argue with anyone that there is simply no other investment that a nation or a society or a city or a community can make than investing in education in general, and particularly science and technology. And I want to emphasize, particularly science and technology is not the same as only science and technology. Investing in other education, in art, in social subjects, in history, in languages, in literature, is of course crucial. And a society that will invest only in science and technology will be a totally sick society. But there are priorities, and within education, science and technology are extremely important, more than ever because of the economic advantage, not because they are more beautiful or more exciting than they were. They were beautiful and exciting, and they remain so. Now, that leads to the involvement of active scientists and research institutes and universities in the world of science education, because who, if not those academic institutions, could change, advance, and update science education? It cannot be left in the hands of only educators and teachers, because that would guarantee a delay of decades in implementing new ideas, new concepts, new technologies, etc. And one of the examples, and this is only example, this is not the main thing, is the introduction of technology, especially information technology, computers and such, to education. At the end of the 80s, some of us were already preaching that you must introduce all of this into the school system. And today, even the most advanced countries in this business have not really changed. The school that children go to today is not that different from the school that I attended. And I attended school many, many, many years ago. And we do not have yet the penetration. At home, yes. In the pockets of the children, yes, but not in the school class. For instance, one of the most important things in education is education, individualized education. Different children have different tastes. One can learn better by looking, the other by hearing. One is more interested in that and the other in the other. One is brilliant but slow. The other is less brilliant but extremely fast. To teach all of them exactly in the same way is difficult, but you have only one teacher. But now with modern technology, they can learn in different ways and different paces and different subjects under one teacher by using the right technology. And this is just one example in which we are failing at the moment. And the overall picture is quite sad because nothing in education is urgent because the results come only after decades. And the politicians usually are not interested in what will happen decades from now. They are mostly interested in the next election, so in the next public opinion poll, and nothing in education will change by the next election.